Good evening. We were warned it wouldn't be good, and today the Premier's worst fears were realised. Sydney recording a triple-digit spike, 112 new COVID cases. 34 of those spent several days in the community while infectious. And while the biggest concern remains in our southwest, tonight the eastern suburbs are back in the spotlight. Mark Burrows begins our coverage.
If you think this lockdown is bad, you are not living in this apartment block in Botany Street, Bondi Junction. Eight people with COVID, five households struggling. Resident Marius De Jager, his wife and one-year-old son are so far negative.
Probably our main concern is, and then people do start getting paranoid, is it getting underneath our doors?
Shopping and all meals are being delivered. The building is surrounded. There are police, health department officials, cleaners, and everywhere private security.
They came into our apartment 2 days ago, tested everyone. I saw the police that was at the front, at the back of my building, and yeah, that we have no information.
A red-hot hotspot where it all started.
Now identified the source, and we'll be working with all residents to ensure we can safely move and provide care for those with COVID in the special health accommodation.
Cases have exploded. 112, 34 moving around while infectious.
We're seeing people unfortunately turn up to waiting rooms of medical centres or GP clinics, or else going into pharmacies when they've got symptoms and unintentionally passing the virus on.
Of all the areas in Sydney, it's Fairfield that right now is of the greatest concern.
Please be aware, right now, Fairfield is the target of this virus in particular.
The fear is that the Delta strain has taken hold in Fairfield, Smithfield, Bosley Park, Fairfield Heights, Fairfield West, Wakeley, Bonnyrigg and West Hoxton.
Every time they go out of their house for an essential good, if they go shopping, they need to assume that someone next to them has COVID.
On Friday, a vaccine hub will open at the Fairfield Showground. The priority, 10,000 teachers and aged care workers.
That's a good start, but we need you to stay there and we need you to provide vaccines for everybody.
And all New South Wales health vaccination centres will now be offering AstraZeneca to those over 40. Under 40s should get the nod from their GP first. The Lake Macquarie Hub at Belmont will open on Friday. So too a clinic on Pitt Street in the CBD. The mass vaccination hub at Macquarie Fields will open at the end of July, the one servicing Wollongong sometime in August. As from today, all workplaces and retail centres must have QR codes.
We will be looking closely at those premises that don't have the QR codes.
At Smithfield, this woman abused staff at a chicken shop when she was asked to wear a mask. As for the lockdown ending on Friday,
given where the numbers are, it's not likely, in fact, almost impossible for us to get out of lockdown on Friday.
If you can see and agree with a lot of the experts that this lockdown will go for at least 3 to 4 weeks.
We won't know the answer as to how long the lockdown will take at this stage, because we need to know, we need to collect the data as to how we can get that number down.
This was a snapshot of Sydney's malaise. These were the celebrations in Melbourne after Italy won the Euro football final. The Sydney version in Leichhardt this morning.
Italia! Italia!
Three supporters. Points at least for trying.
And Mark joins me at the desk. New exposure sites really do underscore the message from health authorities, Mark.
Peter, we've got three fresh venues of concern. The Belmore Medical Centre, Monday the 5th of July. Also, three cases linked to the iMedic Medical Centre, Fairfield, on Thursday the 8th and 9th of July. And to emphasise why authorities are worried about Fairfield, an infected staffer at Australian Visa Now in Fairfield worked there over 6 days while infectious from Monday, July 5 to July 10. To help with vaccinations, AstraZeneca will be available at pharmacies for those over 40. You can book an appointment on the New South Wales Health website. Peter.
Good on you, Mark. Thank you. Let's go to Kate Creedon. She's at Bondi Junction tonight, where residents of a COVID-exposed apartment block are holed up. Kate, how are they going?
Well, Pete, as you'd imagine, this is very new to them. Police arrived this morning, locking the building down and preventing anyone from coming in and out. This was at the request of New South Wales Health after eight people from five households tested positive. Those residents have now been transported to health accommodation while their close contacts remain in the building in isolation. I have spoken with a number of residents on the telephone today. They tell me that they have all tested negative so far. However, a few are still waiting for their results. And this is really just the beginning for them, Peter. Police will remain here for the next 14 days, making sure all residents obey the public health order.
OK, Kate, thank you. Let's move across the metropolitan area to Ruth Wynne Williams. She's at the testing hub at Fairfield Showground this evening. Ruth, good evening to you. How has the community responded after today's high case numbers?
Pete, we are just seeing so many people coming through here to the Fairfield Testing Centre. And while they are being checked here, we now know a medical centre just a few blocks away has been shut down and is right now being deep cleaned. And that has brought a message from our Premier tonight. If you are feeling sick, if you have even the slightest of symptoms, don't go to your doctor. Your first port of call is here, an official testing centre for Pete, a COVID test.
All right, Ruth, thank you. Sydney's COVID cluster has spread interstate with an infectious removalist crossing two state borders and a New South Wales family isolating in Victoria now testing positive. It comes as more states close their borders in a desperate bid to protect themselves.
A line of masked police officers once again guarding the New South Wales-Victorian border, but it seems to have been too late. The Sydney virus had already infiltrated our southern neighbour.
We do have to report two separate further incursions of COVID from New South Wales.
The family of four had returned from New South Wales earlier this month and were in isolation. Two members have tested positive. In another COVID scare, an infectious removalist left Sydney last week, travelled down the Hume Highway, stayed overnight in Victoria on July 8 and visited multiple homes before driving to South Australia the next day and then back to New South Wales. One of his two crew members also testing positive.
There will be exposure sites and we'd expect there will be people required to quarantine as a direct result of that.
New South Wales and the ACT turned into red zones at 11:59 last night. Victorian residents wishing to return face 14 days of quarantine. Permits also given to certain workers and cross-border residents.
I drive back and forth across the border multiple times a day. It's going to slow me down getting the jobs all over the place.
A slow crawl over the border at Albury-Wodonga.
You've got to do what you're going to do, you know.
South Australia is also toughening their border with New South Wales. As of midnight, it will be much harder for their residents to obtain an exemption to enter the state.
We want to seriously turn that tap off.
Queensland's border with New South Wales remains open, but they're closely monitoring sewerage testing and won't hesitate to shut it should the virus leave Sydney.
Even if you are in, you know, regional parts of New South Wales, we are monitoring that very closely and things can change.
Laura Tunstall, Nine News.